I hope this stream doesn't lag, like it did before. My computer and internet is actually good now, so... seriously, let's not screw this up. Yeah, I'm going to be spending a lot of time looking around just to kind of get in the details. It is mildly disappointing that you can't jump in this game, but we'll make do. Ha ha. And don't mind the coughing, because I am a little sick, so. Pressing R1 to card or circle to evade. These controllers are so different from Final Fantasy XV and Kingdom Hearts. This is kind of neat. That's pretty neat. Sector 5, 9:18 and 9:30, 9:46. Oh yeah, totally. I gotta love propaganda. Opens on June 25th at 6 p.m. There's a few things I don't know, remember about the original game, so I'm not sure if a lot of these are references or not, but they're neat nonetheless, and if they are, then that's pretty cool. I just wish I was better with Japanese so I could actually read the signs. Mine. to me. Freaking wedge. As much of a kid as he is in the original game. There's the banter from in this game, based on what I've seen in the demo at PAX, is really fucking great. Not interested what you think. And here's the iconic box chart from Final Fantasy VII, redone in HD. God, I love all the references they put in this game. Well, that's not traversable. I did have to lower my bitrate from 2500 to 1500 to get the stream to stop lagging, so hopefully it works fine now. Because I do have my stream open by my Linux box to keep an eye on it, so if things mess up, I should know. I mean, Punisher mode doesn't really seem that much slower. Wow. And that actually wastes an ATB gauge if you fail to land the attack. Okay, that's good to know. Oh, so just like old Final Fantasy games, dogs are a pain in the ass to kill. Yep. Was that it? That's a shame. Oh well. Hey. I wish you could, like, zoom in and be able to look at things closer. That should be a feature. I did beat the original game, but it's been, like, I don't know, 15 years since I did it. So there are still a lot of things that I don't quite remember, but I should be able to pick out details that were in the original. If I can find them. Yeah, I know. Yeah. As it says that, and I completely spaced doing it. I almost died in the freaking demo just because I wasn't paying attention. That would have been bad. This dog has fire. This quote unquote dog. Some creature that looks more like a freaking curl from Final Fantasy XV with like a dangle thing on its neck instead of having a tail. Did he say I've got your number? Give me a minute, guys. Anyways, back to where we're doing. Just kind of checking out what I can destroy and what I can't. What parts of a terrain are destructible and what's not. All the detail that goes into be making this game. Hey, what's up? Okay, Wedge. Don't get killed yourself. All that freaking Mako pollution in the sky. And the Shinra building way over there, and which reactor is that behind it? It's probably like Sector 4 reactor. Mako way down there and stuff. One thing I kind of do hope is that if they're making this game based solely in Midgar, then I hope that we get to actually explore all the sectors instead of just like Sector 1 and Sector 5 and 7 and then going straight to Shinra Tower like we were in the original game. Those little flashes that Cloud gets in the original game, he was getting like, messages from a certain someone who died. I'm not gonna tell who, but you probably already know. In this version of the game, it seems kinda different. And I'm not gonna talk about why. You can just look and watch. Say something else. That's all you say. Alright. Well, that's it then. Damn, he's good. Tough shit, Barrett. I love the snarky Cloud in this game. Yeah, I've already been doing that game. It's not that the game actually lets you do it before the tutorial telling you that you can do it. Yeah, I know. Really? We're not doing this, OBS. Come on. You're not gonna attack me? Oh, there we go. Yeah, I don't know how the counterattacks really work. Anyways. Yeah, I am letting myself get hit a lot of the time just to, like, kind of test things out. See the dynamics of this game, and I was trying to see how the counterattacks work, but I guess they're a little bit hard to figure out right now. You got this place covered. Where? Hey, over there. waiting for you to give me some dialogue. I'm not entirely sure if you have to actually step over the items that fall out, or they just come to you immediately, or automatically later. Sure. Screw what you've got to say about Tifa and you. Hey, President Shinra, who doesn't have a first name. No. Really, Discord? Or not Discord, OBS? OBS just had to ruin a good scene. I'll try. That too. Here we go. It still kind of sucks that you can't switch between characters while outside of battle. You can only play as Cloud. Although I kind of wonder how that's going to work in the later portions, like part 3 probably, because there's a point in the original game where you lose Cloud for a while. I'm not going to tell why, but you're going to lose Cloud for a while and you have to play as other parts of the party, and so I don't know. Barret isn't, though. Is Barret actually losing hit points during that? What the hell are those hitting? That's weird. You can set them here. So it's L1 and then the buttons. And this was Big Shot in the original game. They renamed it, apparently. Guaranteed to hit, huh? So fire isn't. So you can equip an accessory. I don't think you could do it in the original game. It was just a sword and a defense item. Strength, magic, vitality. Interesting. So magic is different from magic attack and defense. And vitality obviously goes to your hit points and whatnot. Not entirely sure what spirit is or whatnot. Speed can't be your movement speed. It's probably how fast your ATB charges. I doubt it's your attack speed. And luck is kind of default in Final Fantasy games. Classic Buster Sword, being able to slash for steel. Yep. I'm good, unlike Barret. I didn't really get to hear this music. It just seems to kind of loop with this small segment. Alright. Nothing else back here. Looks like there's something back here. You would have missed that. That was just an ether. That's funny. Anyways. Hey, buddy. Apparently you can't actually attack it from behind because they'll just turn around. Alright, magic. Ouch. Yeah. I like how his head stays looking at Barrett while you're moving around while they're talking. That's kind of neat. Tiny little details that they put into the games that most people don't even notice. But they're so great. And talk to Barrett. But. OBS, I swear to God. Turn the fucking audio back on. Guess you just can't get over there. I hope the game doesn't do this regularly. Oh, so it doesn't really tell you, but you can hold R1 and be able to slide down the letters. There was something I wanted to check out before I went over there. I don't remember what. The way these reactors look. Hey, looks tasty. Let's drink some. Let's get drunk on Mako. So, it doesn't really matter what you pick here, because it's kind of easy to get out anyways, this is the first mission. But when you pick 20, Barry's like, cocky, ain't ya? And I'm gonna see what happens when you pick 30. You'd get out in like 10 minutes anyways, so I'm kinda hoping that they do put a 10 minute timer just for a challenge. But we'll see. Fuck you, Barrett. I keep doing that. Surgery, OBS. Save my magic points. I wonder if there's fire damage here. You just simply can't step on it at all. Okay then. I've got an entire 30 minutes, so I can explore a little bit. Look at the details. That's another reason I wanted to put 30 minutes onto it, so that I have time to be able to look around and see the details of the place falling apart. That's horrible as that sounds. I like the fact that they remade the bombing mission music for this specific scene. Like, Nobuo Uematsu's a fucking god as a music composer. Him and Yoko Shimomura both, and Arata Yoshi and Junichi Mitsuda. All these JRPG game makers and composers. Hey buddy, what's up? Just the fucking damage from the Guard Scorpion's laser tail shooting along across the area. Like, those marks are from his laser tail. All the falling debris and everything. In the original game, you only got 10 minutes on an active battle system, or active time battle system. And I got done in about 5 minutes. So I basically spent the other, like, 5 minutes going around battling things just to get up my levels before the base exploded. Yeah, this is a part in the original game where you have to... where you have to go over and help Jessie out. And get her leg out from under debris. And there's the core over there. Is that traversable? I kind of hope so. No, I think that's right where you have to go. A Moogle medal, huh? What is that? Also, there's the, oh, that's the map. I completely spaced that. Pressing the, center button of the controller. Opens a map? I didn't even know about that. That's what I tried to open, though. What is that item? Key items. So it's something that you can sell or trade to collectors, I guess. I hope Moogles actually show up in this game. Final Fantasy XV just had a Moogle doll that you can throw at enemies to leave battle but that just wasn't enough. I hope that we actually get Moogles in this. And we get a Chocomog materia, but like that's to summon Chocobos and materia, or and Moogles. Yeah, the banter in this game is great. And Barret's over there climbing that ladder. And here we are meeting back up with him. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, Cloud obviously does a lot more damage. Barret's kind of more of a magic user early on. He's got Thunder, which most mechs are weak against. I have to wonder how much damage these do compared to my magic. Also, as you can see from the command mode, that the timer actually goes down to 1 point per second, which means that the command mode is 1/100th of a second. So that's how you can tell exactly how fast the bullet time is in this game, is by looking at the timer up there. Bullet time is 1/100th of a second. It really sucks that you can't jump in this game. They could add so many more explorable places if you could. You do have to walk into them to pick them up. Alright. Good to know. I like how you can kind of light up the area that's too dark by flashing that things. I'm going. things to blow up. Hey, post change that replaced the ones I just used. See what I mean, too? All that exploring, and I'm still only like 8 minutes in. 7.5. I could easily get out of here in 10 minutes without doing the exploring. I can probably still do that anyways. Dead. Oh my god, Barrett. Shut up, Barrett. You're not Prompto. You may have a gun, but you're not Prompto. Oh god, I just noticed the fucking similarities. Kill me. And I'm going backwards. Yeah, a lot of people don't use the dash button. You press L3 to dash. Okay. I'm fine. I should have been doing this all this time. So, yeah. All this exploring I did, and I still got out in 10 minutes. Like, just barely 10 minutes, but still 10 minutes. So, if there was a 10-minute timer, I could have still easily done this. I didn't need 20, or let alone 30 minutes. So I kind of hope they do put a 10-minute timer in, just for a challenge. Yeah, if they're gonna blow up the place, might as well just quicken the thing so we can take them down with it, right? Yeah, cool it, Barrett. No need to stress over an elevator. Don't stress over things you can't control, that's the point. And here's the end of a demo. And this has to be one of the coolest and most realistic explosions I've ever seen in the games. Like the debris that just flies all across the entire sector and onto Sector 8. Like they literally blew up a power plant, a reactor. Like that's going to cause a lot of damage to the city itself, not just shut off the power. That's kind of something that we didn't really see in the original game is... Fuck you, OBS. Is the aftermath of basically what happened. Like, we saw some things on fire, but we didn't really see the full extent of the damage that was done to the city. And the effect that it had on people. Granted, people on the upper plates kind of treat people in the slums like trash, so I guess I guess Avalanche doesn't really care about what happens with them, but it still would be nice to kind of see that. Yeah, I'm gonna get the physical copy, so I'm not gonna get digital. I don't really care to try the classic mode much. I mean, it's basically playing the game as the original Final Fantasy VII game. You just have it on easy mode and then you select your commands and everything, and the game basically does basic attacks for you. Like, that's neat and everything, but I kind of like the active battle system that this has, so I'm gonna stick to that when I do the full game. And we'll go from there. But it is neat for the people who do want that kind of battle system, and it's kind of nice that they put it in. I love the remake of the main Final Fantasy theme, Prelude. Like, all the remake of the music that they did in this game is just great. And I'm seriously glad that Nobu Uematsu came back to redo the music for this game, because no better composer would be the one that originally made the music. So, only he knows how to remake his own music. And Takahiro Ishimoto did a pretty good job in Dissidia and Crisis Core, but you can't get better than the expert. And then we have Tetsuya Nomura directing this game, and he did all the Kingdom Hearts series, and the first part of Final Fantasy XV before he passed it off to Tabata, and then Tabata left Square Enix. So yeah, Tetsuya Nomura is going to be directing this entire game from start to finish, and now it's finally going to be released on April 10th, so... We got that to look forward to, unless they push it back another month. Hopefully not. But yeah, like it says, the demo is a work in progress, so things could be different in the final game, which makes sense that your save file can't be transferred to the final game, because if they make changes, then that save file would no longer work. So, unlike Mr. Dungeon DX, where the beginning is basically how it's gonna be no matter what. Yeah, they're constantly making changes to this game and updating graphics and updating mechanics and story and gameplay and everything, so I'm fine with the save data not being transferable to the full game once it comes out. And the opening mission isn't really that long anyways, and I don't even mind redoing it. So yeah, we'll see how the full game is, and I hope that it's actually as good as they're saying that it is, and that they're hoping that it's gonna be, because this is Square Enix's baby. Final Fantasy VII is the most praised Final Fantasy game in Square Enix. Even though 6 is actually my favorite, and they've actually talked about remaking 6 later or 2. 7 is basically what made them. And the way that they're going right now with kind of the mess that Final Fantasy 15 was and everything else, they really need to make Final Fantasy 7 Remake good. Because this is either going to make or break them. If it fails, then they're going to have so much backlash, like worse than Pokemon Sword and Shield did for Nintendo and the Pokemon Company and Game Freak. The backlash for Final Fantasy VII would be incredibly severe, because we've waited over 20 years for this. 1997 is 23 years. So, let's hope that it's good, and let's hope that they pull through. And I kind of have hope, but we'll see. So yeah, that's all for this stream. I'm going to be posting this to YouTube, so it'll be there permanently and everything. Sorry for the little glitches in the beginning with OBS being a piece of crap, but hopefully with the reduced bitrate down to 1500 from 2500, I shouldn't have any more lags or skips or freezes or anything. So once I do stream the full game, which I'm going to be streaming Pokemon Mystery Dungeon DX first, when it comes out on Friday. Hopefully when I stream the full game for this, it'll actually work out well. And OBS won't be a piece of crap like it was today and before and everything. I've got new hardware on my computer and whatnot, so things should be good. And we'll see what happens. Anyways, that's all for today, so see you guys later.